within cells, there are lots of molecules, proteins and RNAs. Their interaction basically give rise to their behaviors. We often find that they don't work like a clock, in that everything is like 100% precise. What you see is that things tend to fluctuate because of the fact that different proteins and genes, they are all connected to each other in these cells. Just like an electrical circuit, you can expect that these fluctuations can transmit from one gene to another. What we found is that that can be regulated by the environment. When the external situations changes, like in terms of like an infection or in terms of temperature, that's what we mean by environment.
With newer technologies, we can actually measure individual cells and then look at how not only does the cell change its average behavior, but how does each individual cell behave within the population. With this chip, we can do anywhere between 4,000 and 9,000 different gene measurements at the same time.
And that generated massive amounts of data that the only way to analyze it is by computation.
And so we are trying to infer the inner workings of the cells, and cells do not reveal their secrets easily. We can try to look at how genes vary along with each other in order to infer these types of different networks where each circle here is a gene and then there are these connections between genes. Between different environments, they could be rewired quite differently.
In a situation where you get infected, the more variation you have, the more diversity of responses you have. But if every single cell is doing the same thing, that may actually be quite detrimental, for example, because the microbe can take advantage and can basically evade that protection. The next step is really to connect the phenomena we observe here to the higher level biological functions, such as how individuals respond to infections.